Okay, episode one of the practice room. This is a little experiment. I'm just going to take a look inside my practice routine as often as I can hit record on the camera. I hope to upload a lot of these. This is the first one. Just rocking the GoPro, trying to keep it super simple and give you a look at what goes into the day-to-day. I really don't often sit down with a dedicated thing of like, okay, I'm going to practice major arpeggios. Although it sounds like I probably should. And I just kind of feel it out. Hands are a little cold right now. Just feeling out where I want to go. It's Tuesday, I haven't played since Saturday, so these are the first, literally the first few notes back here. So I'll try and keep the talking to a minimum and just get on with my routine and give anyone who's listening or watching a little look at what that entails. And kind of okay. Oh, a little stretch. See where the fingers are. Make sure I'm not putting any unnecessary strain on anything. Oh. Ooh. Okay. It's funny how I think of A flat major, and I think of A flat when I'm playing minor, I think of it as A flat minor, but when I'm playing G flat, I think G flat major, and I think F sharp minor. Think or hear or see or whatever it is. I'm not sure I'm really thinking about it, but I feel F sharp minor and G flat major. Never F sharp major or G flat minor. And hopefully the fluidity between the major and minor shapes is identical. The minor, I haven't been doing that long, only the last like 6 months or so. But this major shape I've been doing since almost day one. So it's quite natural. And the minor should be just as natural. It's starting to feel pretty good. Come on. Should I go up major, down minor? You only have to change the third. Shouldn't be that difficult. Just put your fingers in a bit of a different position. That's okay. Okay, fingers are definitely starting to feel warm. Nice little stretch. Make sure I'm not overdoing it.
Thank you.
Okay, so. I have a couple of things like melodic ideas, licks, if you will, part of my vocabulary. That one I stole from Mike Brecker. Gets us out into this kind of. Gets us out from C minor to D major. But it's something I use kind of early on when I'm improvising like that to see where my chops are. I felt pretty warm, and then I was like, oh, let me try that, because it's kind of a tough little shape. And it wasn't as smooth as I would like, so it told me I have to kind of dial it back a little bit. Okay, that's a tough one. Better than it has in the past. That's some Tim Miller 212 stuff. Because I'm in my studio and I'm working on a bunch of shit at the same time, I get to see if this new podcast that we just started will render. So that can run in the background. I love tasks that run in the background while I'm practicing. Oh, yeah. Thank you. a sweep or sound like a sweep. It's going to be way faster than that. So I got to start practicing it way slower. Metronome designed by EUM Lab. I love this thing, but it takes so long to load. That's crazy. Oh, now I have it accented. No, thank you. I just want even. Listening and not watching on YouTube, I just looked at my clock and it's okay, it's this time and I'm gonna set myself 10 minutes to practice this thing, so strap in, it's gonna be 10 minutes of just this. Again, I'm hitting it too, half step up. Wow, Total brain fart. Let's do it dry. Actually, didn't do a full 10, but what is that? Timeline, Pamathini, jeez. That with the Mike Brecker record so much, articulating every note. What is it?
Thank you.
Connection. Now I can't remember. Get up to that note. Maybe I can even add that. It's a long line. I won't be using that very often. Yeah. Episode one. If you're watching on YouTube, comment below the video. Let me hear your feedback. If this long form thing is of any use, this kind of inside look at what I do every day, daily basis, all the mistakes, all the searching, finding, repetition, and just kind of what goes into putting it all together. Leave me some comments below the video on YouTube. If you're listening as a podcast, maybe go to YouTube and leave your comments as well. That'd be a good place to aggregate all that stuff. Either way, that was our first experimental episode of the practice room.